Okay, so we're moving on to part three of the analog tape series, looking at analog recorders of the past based on the ones in my collection. Next in line is the all-familiar cassette deck. This was the most successful commercially of all analog recorders, hands down. This format was solely responsible for what we call today file sharing. All this passing music around for free started with this. Cassettes were an easy way to record your own music. Not to mention, this was the most feasible format to use as a portable recorder. This is what most people know as the Walkman or mini stereo cassette player. This was considered portable. You can put four AA batteries and your cassette and a pair of headphones, and lo and behold, you can actually walk and clip this onto your belt and have music in your ears of your choice, not the radio, at your disposal. These were the game changers. The quality wasn't the best. It was nowhere near the type of quality you would achieve on a reel-to-reel recorder. It was better than an 8-track. That's for sure. But it was the most commercially successful. So in a record store, up until the 90s, you still saw cassettes for sale with albums on them. The Walkman that was created by Sony is the equivalent of today's iPod or iPad or any digital media player. I mean, they were everywhere. They were revolutionary. It changed everything. Cassette tapes recorded and played back at a speed of 4 3/4 centimeters, not inches per second. I think that's about 1 and something inches per second. So you can see the difference in tape speed between analog reel-to-reel and cassette recorders. There's not enough good things to say about what cassette tape did for the average musician. So to expand on that, last but not least, is this Tascam 4-track recorder / mixer / everything you can ever want. This was your equivalent to having a software program. This was your Pro Tools. This was your Nuendo. This was your Cubase. This was your digital software recorder. This used standard cassettes and allowed you to record 4 tracks that were syncable. What I mean is you could sync this to your actual sequencer. You could also bounce down tracks. So you can record 3 tracks, bounce that down to 1 track. A lot of demos were made this way. This is your affordable production tool. And even in saying that, it wasn't that affordable. I mean, for the price I paid for this, you could probably buy a number of software tools today, computer included. It was a tool that really taught the user how to record, because you had to make so many decisions before you committed to tape. There really wasn't much of a second chance once you started bouncing down. Once your tracks were recorded, you never had to go anywhere to mix down because the mixer and everything was built in. You could also route an effects unit to it, which I did, and made a number of recordings on this. That wraps this one up. Thanks for watching. If you want to see the last episode on 8-track recorders, you can click here. Otherwise, please subscribe to me on YouTube, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, and pick up a copy of my current album, The Daydream Sound 1, on Bandcamp. Peace.